Hello friends, today we will study 3D transformation. So transformation means to convert or to change, which we have already discussed in 2D transformation. So 3D means three dimensional, which means that three axes will come into picture. So three dimensional transformation, that is 3D transformation, is similar to 2D transformation. Rather, in 3D transformation we are extending 2D transformation by considering one more parameter, that is Z coordinate, because in 2D we were considering one plane, that is XY plane, and in 3D we will consider X, Y, Z, means three axes will come into picture. So in 2D transformation we were having scaling, rotation, translation, transformation. In 3D also this all will come into picture. So now first we will convert 3D point into matrix form. So first we will transform 3D point, that is I will name it as P, X, Y, Z. In 2D it were having X and Y because it was having two planes. Here we will have three planes, so X, Y, Z, that is three axes X, Y, Z. Now for converting this point P, that is coordinate form, into matrix form, that is matrix form. So I will write as P in matrix form, X, Y, Z, 1. So this is the conversion of coordinate form into matrix form. So now we will start the first transformation, that is scaling transformation. Scaling. So scaling in 3D, scaling, which we already discussed, that scaling means either enlarging or reducing the original figure. For example, this is the figure. If you want to enlarge this figure, the figure will become somewhat this way, which means that I am enlarging along X direction, I am enlarging along Y direction. So you can see here the size and width increased in this direction also and in this direction also. So scaling in 2D is just similar to scaling in 3D, which means that we will scale along X direction, that is it is termed as SX. If you will scale along Y direction, it will termed as SY. But in 3D one more parameter come into picture, that is Z coordinate. So we will use scaling along Z direction, because if you are enlarging any 3D object, so we have to enlarge along Z direction also. For that we will enlarge, that is we will scale along Z direction. So I will name it as SZ. So for scaling in 2D, the matrices were in 3x3 form, okay, but scaling in 3D the matrix will be 4x4 form. So for scaling for 2D, the matrices were SX 0 0 0, SY 0 0 0 1. So it was in 3x3 matrix form. So for scaling in 3D, since it is 3D, one more parameters will come, that is Z parameter, that is Z axis. The matrix will become SX 0 0 0 0, SY 0 0 0 0, SZ 0 0 0 0 1. So now it is of the form 4 into 4 matrix. So this is the scaling matrix for 3D. Now the next transformation we will do or we will study for 3D is translation. Translation in 3D. The name itself says translation means to translate. Means translate, that is, which means moving from one point to another linearly. In 2D, we were translating along x direction and along y direction. And in 3D, we will translate along x direction, that is along this plane, along y direction and along z direction. 3D means it will be perpendicular to the board. So translation means moving from one point to another linearly. So the parameters which were used for translation, it was tx, ty and tz, because in 3D we take one more axis, that is z axis. So I will use tz. Tx means translation along x direction, and ty means translation along y direction, and tz means translation along z direction. So now the standard matrix for translation in 3D will become 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 tx ty tz 1. So this is standard translation matrix for 3D. So now next transformation we will do is rotation. Rotation in 3D. So rotation means rotating the object in clockwise or anti-clockwise direction. So rotation in 3D is slightly different from rotation in 2D. In 2D, for performing rotation, we are having one plane, that is xy plane. So this is that xy plane. If we are moving in this direction, then we will consider it as anti-clockwise. If you are moving in this direction, then we will consider it as clockwise. So in xy plane we can rotate the object. So for anti-clockwise direction we take the angle as positive, and for clockwise direction we take the angle as negative. So in 2D we are having one plane, so we will perform rotation. We will rotate a point or object in that plane. So there will be a clockwise rotation and anti-clockwise rotation. But in the case of 3D, we are having three axes. So in case of 3D, we are having three axes, that is x, y, z. So we will have three planes, that is xy plane, xz plane and yz plane. So in 3D, for performing rotation, we will require to which axis the rotation is to be performed and at what angle the rotation has to be done. So two things is to be known while performing rotation in 3D, that is to which axis. First is the axis, to which axis, and second is at what angle? So for performing rotation in 3D, these two things is to be specified. So in 2D, to detect clockwise and anticlockwise rotation was simple, but to detect in 3D the clockwise and anticlockwise rotation, we see from positive half of axis towards origin. So from this we can detect the clockwise and anticlockwise rotation. Means for detecting the clockwise and anticlockwise rotation, we have to view from positive half of axis towards the origin. So the positive angle produces anticlockwise rotation and negative angle produces clockwise rotation. So now we will see rotation about x-axis. So 3D rotation about x-axis. The matrices for 3D rotation about x-axis is 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, cos theta, sin theta, 0, 0, minus sin theta, cos theta, 0, 0, 0, 1. So this is the standard matrices for rotation about x-axis. So the viewer is viewing from this direction. So the rotation, if it is rotating in this direction, then it is considered as anticlockwise. If it is rotating in this direction, it is considered as clockwise. So this is the matrices for rotation about x-axis. So next we will study rotation about y-axis. So rotation about y-axis. So the standard matrices for rotation about y-axis is cos theta 0, sin theta 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, minus sin theta 0, cos theta 0, 0, 0, 1. So this is standard matrices for rotation about y-axis. So for rotation, viewer is here. So if you are rotating in this direction, it is considered as anticlockwise, which is also called as counterclockwise. If you are rotating in this direction, so this is rotation is called as clockwise rotation. So this is a sign convention because the positive angle produces anticlockwise rotation and negative angle produces clockwise rotation. So this is the matrices for rotation about y-axis. Now the next is rotation about z-axis. So 3D rotation about z-axis. So the matrices for rotation about z-axis is cos theta, sin theta, 0, 0, minus sin theta, cos theta, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. So this is matrices for rotation about z-axis. Now the sign convention, since it is z-axis, the viewer will be here and the rotation, if his rotation is in this direction, it is considered as anticlockwise. If the rotation is in this direction, it is considered as clockwise. So this is a sign convention for rotation and this is the matrices for rotation about z-axis.